fades and all is stripped away, and I simply go. Longing just to breathe something that's of worth, that will bless your heart. I'll bring you more than a song, for a song in itself is not what you have required. You search much deeper within, through the way things appear, you're looking into my heart. I'm coming back to
Maker, our Redeemer, our Sustainer, the God that is above all gods. Father in heaven, you are the righteous God, the lily of the valley, the bright and morning star. Father in heaven, we come to you, mighty God, because all other gods, they are the works of men, but you are the most high God. So, mighty God, we lift you above all else this morning. Father in heaven, you are able to do exceedingly abundantly above we can ever ask or even imagine. So as we come this morning, mighty God, we want to say thanks. Thank you that you are our Father. Thank you, mighty God, that you love us in such a way that you gave your only Son. Thank you, Father, even for your blessed Holy Ghost, our comforter, our teacher, our healer. Oh God, we give you praise. We thank you, Lord, for this privilege that we have come this morning. We can come this morning because in your presence there is fullness of joy. At your right hand there are pleasures forevermore. Father, let me thank you this morning for fellowship. We thank you, mighty God, for this liberty wherein you have made us free. Free to lift our hands. Free to worship. Free to praise you. Free to tell of your goodness and of your love. Father, let me be free this morning. All because of the blood that was shed at Calvary. All because of that resurrection power. Oh God, we are free this morning. Father, even as we come this morning, God, we just put ourselves in your hand. Father, even every situation, Lord God, we put them to you. God Almighty, you alone know, you are able, mighty God. So we thank you. Our cares, our concerns, yes, Lord. Our joys, our sorrows. Father, we pray for your church, Lord, church universal, the church that you have established. God Almighty, you tell us that days of hell cannot prevail against your church. So God, as we stand on your promises this morning, we pray, Lord God, that whatever will take place here this morning, it will be to your honor and to your glory. Father, we pray this morning for our community.
Your word tells us that one will change.
guide us and direct us. Those who are sick, Lord, physically, spiritually, emotionally, mighty God. You are the great healer. Oh God, it's no secret what you can do. So we just leave ourselves in your hands, mighty God. And we say, have your own sweet way. Bless, guide, guard, and direct us as we say that. In the mighty name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus. Aren't you happy to be in the house of the Lord this morning?
Yes.
Just to give him praise and to honor his name. After all, he deserves it. God is amazing. Bless the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah. Yes. Bless his holy name. Thank you, Lord.
Cast your burdens on Jesus.
Thank you. here to declare to you, church, that right now, without celebrities, we are in the presence of the indescribable God, the unchangeable God. We are in the presence of the miracle working God, the God who is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we could ever ask or think. So let's keep the worship going.
Push back against the dark forces, God, that come against our
proper mental health and strength for our educators, Lord God. It is a rough space up there. And Lord God, as they come back together in this space, we pray fresh anointing over every education center, every institution, every school, principal, teachers, ward, whatever part they play. For the parents of God, we know some of them have it so difficult. Father, we pray that you will help them to find a way. Help them to find you. Father, we bless your name because you are an awesome God. You are a loving God. You are forgiving. Father, we thank you for the healing even in our sanctuary right now, the deliverance. There are people come wanting this morning. We thank you that they believe and would have received your Holy Spirit. Father, we thank you that we will hide your word in our hearts. We thank you, Jesus, that you are God. You're God of our lives, you're God of our situations. And we just hand everything to you now. We pray you will take over the rest of this service, Lord God. Full control. We give you full control.
So that's Genesis 4, 1 through to 7. And it reads, "And Adam knew Eve, his wife, and she conceived and bare Cain, and said, I have gotten a man from the Lord. And she again bare his brother Abel. And Abel was a keeper of sheep, but Cain was a tiller of the ground. And in process of time it came to pass, that Cain brought of the fruit of the ground an offering unto the Lord. And Abel, he also brought of the firstlings of his flock and of the fat thereof. And the Lord had respect unto Abel and to his offering, but unto Cain and to his offering he had not respect. And Cain was very wroth, and his countenance fell. And the Lord said unto Cain, Why art thou wroth? And why is thy countenance fallen? 7 and last. If thou doest well, shalt thou not be accepted? And if thou doest not well, sin lieth at the door. And unto thee shall be his desire, and thou shalt rule over him." This is a portion of God's word where we honor by saying,
"Receive the servant of the Lord.
Almighty God, we give you glory. We give you thanks. We lift you up. Oh, Heavenly Father, even now as I come before you, I pray into me, mighty God. Oh, mighty God, you know the limitation. Oh, you know nothing have I have but simply to you, Almighty God. And so even now I pray for a word, even now, a word from you, mighty God. A word to build us up, mighty God. A word to change us. A word to challenge us, mighty God. A word, oh Lord, to keep us going in the name of Jesus. Righteous God, let your will be done, even now, in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Bless the name of Jesus. I just want to give God thanks to be in his house. Just want to give him glory and praise because he is worthy. And I just want to give God thanks for you to be in his house. Yes. Sister, talk about one shall chase 1,000, two shall put 10,000. And so as we come together, join forces in the army to lift up the name of Jesus, to proclaim this message to somebody out there that Jesus saves, he keeps and he's satisfied. Oh, bless the name of Jesus. Bless the name of Jesus. We need a word. We need a word. We need a word from him. And so, just want to say the topic and the message was missing from your program. Yes, receive it late, but we just want to look at Genesis 4, 1 to 7, as was read. And the thought that I have, check your worship offering. Check your worship offering. Bless the name of Jesus. Yes, we can put in it. Oh, the offering would be money. Oh, what this offering we are looking at is your offering of worship. Oh, your offering of worship. You have left your own or even in your prayer room, when you step out each day, when you wake up each morning, oh, check your worship offering. Yes. What motive do you have in terms of worship? What is your motive all about? Blessed be the name of the Lord. Check your worship offering. Jeremiah 17:10 tells us, I, the Lord, search the heart. I try the reins, even to give every man according to his ways and according to the fruit of his doing. So this morning, brothers and sisters, you and I will come here. Oh, mighty God, and sometimes it will be our pretense, but the Lord knows. Oh, the Lord knows. And so I say to check your worship offering. Oh, we say, I give myself away. Oh, but many times we are only about some percent. Oh, many times we are not giving the full. Many times we say, no, I cannot go. And my sister said, oh, she was feeling down. And so I'm not going to go to church today. I don't want to feel like worshiping the Lord today. But if I stay back here, mighty God, and if I go here, blessed be the name of the Lord Jesus. So I say to us this morning, check your worship offering. Oh, because many times we see, oh Lord, that many times we want to offer up some worship. We want to offer up some offering. Oh, but many times that offering is not acceptable. Why? Because it is a personal gain. Blessed be the name of the Lord. And so as we're going to go into this scripture, oh, we're going to understand this morning that when we come to worship, oh, the song said, let me lose myself and find the Lord in thee. May myself be slain. Oh, see, only you. Oh, this morning, I don't matter about my wife. Oh, I don't matter about you beside me. Oh, let me lose myself and find the Lord in thee. Oh, this morning is a personal relationship. Oh, blessed be the name of the Lord. The Bible tells us, as we read in Proverbs 16 and verse 2, all the ways of a man are clean in his own eyes, but the Lord weighs the spirit. Oh, the Lord weighs the spirit. The Lord knows what is going on inside of our heart. The Lord knows what is going on inside. And so you will see me on the outside. Oh, I look so innocent. Oh, I look like I cannot.
Lord, all of my worship, no one,
Oh, blessed be the name of the Lord. Oh, somebody decide to let them know that, oh, you won't let them rush the Lord for you. Oh, you will do it. Oh, you will do it as long as you have let you breath. Oh, blessed be the name of the Lord. Yes. And so as we go into the scripture this morning, oh, Genesis 4, reading from verse 1 to 7. And Adam knew Eve, his wife, and she conceived, yes, and she conceived and bare Cain, and said, I have got a man from the Lord. Yes, Adam and Eve, as Cain came forth, oh, they said, yes, with the Lord, that a man child was born. And so they looked unto this child, oh, to bring great things. It was great hope and expectation for this child. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Parents, oh, the Bible tells you to train up a child in the way he or she should go, that when he or she is old, he will not depart. Many times as your child comes, you are saying, oh, yes, man, this one is the one that I love. This one that I'm going to look, this one is going to carry. Oh, the mantle when I should move on. Blessed be the name of the Lord. But this morning they couldn't see inside of Cain. Oh, they couldn't see inside of Cain this morning. Oh, and later on, as the Bible tells, and she again bear his brother Abel. And Abel was a keeper of the sheep, but Cain was a tiller of the ground. Yes, in our time we'll say farmer, one was shepherd. And in the process of time it came to pass that Cain brought of the fruit of the ground an offering unto the Lord. And Abel, he also brought of the firstling of his flock and of the fat thereof. And the Lord had respect unto Abel and unto his offering. Yes. And so we'll go again from verse 3. And in the process of time, it came to pass that Cain brought of the fruit of the ground an offering unto the Lord. What did Cain bring? Cain brought an offering. Yes, Cain brought an offering of the fruit of the ground. And it said, Abel in 4, and he also brought of the firstling of his flock, and of the fat thereof. When it was time for harvest, so one was doing the farming, one was keeping watch over the flocks, and later on, harvest time came, reaping time. Oh, it bring forth crops upon crops, oh, new chocolates, yes, from the sheep, new ones. And so, because of all they were grown up, Adam and Eve, they know that they need to offer an offering to the Lord, because the Lord, he is to be reverenced, he is to be praised, he is to be feared. And so, when the fullness of time came, as the Bible tells, they brought their gift. One gift was accepted, while the other was rejected. Why? Why was one accepted, while the other was rejected? Check your worship offering, my brothers and sisters. Oh, why one was not accepted by the Lord? As it is said, Abel also brought a gift, the best of the firstborn, the best lamb from the flock. So we see Abel was going and searching and looking at them and saying, oh, yes, this one look good. No, but this one look better. No, this one is the best one. And so he picked that best one and offered it to the Lord. But as we see here, what Cain did, oh, the crops bear fruit much. But I'm not going to take up this one, man. I'm not going to carry that one. I don't have time to search you. I don't have any time to, I don't have time to look for any best one now. Whatever. You know, these are my things. You know, so I'm not going to choose this one. Yeah, this one, I don't really use this one much. So I'm going to offer this one. Blessed be the name of the Lord. And so I say to us, check your worship offering. If he has been good to you, if he has been wonderful to you, why not offer him your best? Why not look for the best? Or why not be the best for him? Blessed be the name of the Lord. Why not give him the best? Why not give him the 100%? Blessed be the name of the Lord. And so he said, the Lord accepted Abel's gift, but he did not accept Cain and his gift. Blessed be the name of the Lord. As he said in verse 4, and the Lord had respect unto Abel and to his offering. These two things we have seen there. The Lord had respect unto the person. Blessed be the name of the Lord. And then the offering. Blessed be the name of the Lord. So I say to us to check your offering. Because as the Bible tells us, many times if any one of us have a fault with our brother, and we come with our gift on our offering, what we need to do is to lay the gift here. Oh, blessed be the name of the Lord. And make peace. Blessed be the name of the Lord. So the Lord is the one that searches the heart. And so as you bring your gift to the Lord will look at the giver in the name of Jesus. And then he will look at the gift. And so the Lord will look at the giver first. Blessed be the name of the Lord. And so I said to check your worship offering. What kind of motive you have in giving that gift? What kind of motive you have in coming with that worship? Blessed be the name of the Lord. Oh, blessed be the name of the Lord. He is worthy. And so he did not accept Cain and his gift. And what happened? This made Cain very angry. Yes. But unto Cain and to his offering. Yes. So the Bible tells us again, unto Cain, the person, and then to his offering. Oh, two things. Oh, Cain's heart was right. And two, he didn't take up the best gift to the Lord. He didn't take up the best gift. And these two things that we can see here in terms of giving. You know, in those times, in accordance to law, oh, when you give up offering, you should give a blood offering. And so Abel was going according to what was prescribed here in Leviticus. Oh, to offer a blood sacrifice as an atonement. Blessed be the name of the Lord. And yes, the Lord accepts sacrifice of fruits and grain as well. That is a sacrifice the Lord accepted as well, according to the Leviticus law. Not like so him, it is that Cain come, he couldn't bring fruits and grain. No, he could have bring fruits and grain. But what? He should have bring the best of it. Blessed be the name of the Lord. He should have taken the best of it. Because what? This Lord has been good to us. This Lord has carried us through. This Lord has been wonderful to us. Because he brought us out of the miry clay. He put a song in our mouth to sing. Oh yes. Oh mighty God, you have come to my house. And so you ask for a drink. And so I'm going to go there and take my plastic cup. I don't want to give you my glass there in the glass case. I don't want to give you that. Oh, blessed be the name of the Lord. That means I'm no such a good friend. Oh, I'm no such, oh, a welcome person. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Give up your best. Blessed be the name of the Lord. And so Cain, give any gift. And he expect to be accepted. And so he was very angry. And so the Lord, knowing the heart, and what the Lord says. What the Lord said, and Cain was very wroth, and his countenance fell. And the Lord said to Cain, why art thou wroth, and why is thy countenance fallen? If thou doest well, shall thou not be accepted? Blessed be the name of the Lord. The Lord is a way maker. Oh, the Lord is not willing that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance. So the Lord was saying, come on, Cain. Oh, if you do well, oh, yes, you will be accepted. Come on. Even if you realize you have brought the wrong thing, oh, even if you go back and bring something better, blessed be the name. and waiting, already and waiting for you, my brothers and sisters. Yes, but that was not what Cain intended. Oh, he didn't have that intention. And the Lord said, if thou doest well, shalt thou not be accepted? And if thou doest not well, sin like. Yes. Yes. Acceptance. Acceptance, young people, is a challenge many times. All we face to be acceptable when we go there in our group, to be accepted when we travel, to be accepted in the workplace. Oh, but come on, could you not be sold out for the Lord? Oh, could you not be sold out for the Lord? Oh, could you not be sold out? Oh, yes. The Lord said you will be accepted if you do what is right. Oh, so many times in the group, many times amongst your peers, they wanted you to do different things. Oh, come on, we can go and try this. Come on, you can try this. Give it a try. Oh, but no. You do not well if you do wrong. Oh, you do not well if you do wrong. Because what? If you refuse to do what is right, then watch out. It's what the Lord was saying to Cain. Watch out. Sin is crouching at the door. Oh, eager to control you. Oh, but you must subdue it. Yes, sin shall not reign over a mortal body, brothers and sisters. Oh, sin shall not reign. Come on, let's watch. Oh, check your worship this morning. Oh, you come to worship and you realize, boy, oh, I'm trying to give up my best. Oh, but I am not receiving anything. Oh, the Bible says you ask and you have not. Oh, because you ask amiss. Oh, you ask to obtain it because of your personal gain. Oh, come on, let's be sold out. Oh, come on, let's give up of our best. Oh, expecting nothing in the name of Jesus. Because he has been good to us. Oh, he has been wonderful to us. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Yes. This is one of the challenges we face. One of the challenges we see happening around us. You know what the Bible tells us? If my people humble, blessed be the name of the Lord, humble, oh, turn from their wicked ways. Oh, we see that so many, the hearts of men is desperately wicked. Oh, you see the heart. Oh, you see the heart. Oh, as you travel out there, you have to be careful what you are doing. Because if you step on somebody called right now, oh, the angriness is there. Oh, it is built up. Oh, we have heard it on the news. Even for $100, oh, somebody will take your life. Almighty God, we glorify, we look to you. Oh, we come against that spirit. Oh, that spirit that wants to take life. Because our Lord Jesus come that we might have life. Oh, and have it more abundantly. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Yes, check our offering. Check our worship offering. Amen. Give of his first fruit. Oh, he look for the best. Oh, he look for the best to give it unto the Lord. Oh, it's sacrifice. Hebrews 11 tells us, blessed be the name of the Lord. Hebrews 11, as the Bible tells us, without faith, it is impossible to please God. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Yes. And as we see, he said, by faith, for by it the elders obtained a good report. Verse 4, by faith, Abel offered unto God a more excellent sacrifice than Cain, by which he obtained witness that he was righteous. God testified of his gift, and by it he being dead, yet speaketh. Blessed be the name of the Lord. By faith. So when we check our worship offering, when we come into worship, knowing by faith, if he be lifted up from this earth, oh, he will do our joy. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Oh, he said, that if he be lifted up, oh yes, he will do the joy. Oh, as we see, yes, it is said, Abel also brought a gift. The best of the firstborn lamb from his flock. The Lord accepted Abel and his gift. It was time to worship. It was time to worship. Time to give thanks to God for the great harvest. Many times when you are out here and you have excelled, education, in your job, crops, oh, and you look and everything was flourishing, was going good. Is that time come when you should offer worship? Because it didn't come from your hands. Oh, it didn't come from your hands. Oh, and Cain and Abel understood that worship is hollow and empty without giving. Yes. They understood what worship and sacrifice was meant to be. But in spite of that, Cain didn't look for the best. Cain didn't look for the best. He believed that he can approach, oh, the Almighty, the All-Powerful, God anyway, with anything. Remember, the Lord doesn't really need our gift. Oh, he has everything already. Oh, he doesn't need those things. Blessed be the name of the Lord. As the Bible tells us, a broken and a contrite heart he will not despise. So that's what he wants us to give. Oh, to give him our heart. To give him our heart. Abel went to worship God and took the best that he had. This morning, have you taken your best? Have you taken your best this morning? Have you taken your best when you wake up each day? Oh, when you step out there, have you taken your best? Blessed be the name of the Lord. He looked for the best. That's what Abel did. He looked for the best. He looked for the best firstborn. This act was accepted by God. God knew that Abel brought his best that he had. He honored God by giving his best. Giving from the best. Many times, if we should put in money in this text, many times we'll say, boy, I can't give so much. I can't give this that I need to give. Whatever they are asking for, I cannot give that. No, I can't give so much, so I go over the other side and take from there. I cannot give. Blessed be the name of the Lord. But what Jesus taught us in St. Matthew 12 and verse 43 to 44. Blessed be the name of the Lord. When the unclean spirit is gone out of a man, he walketh. Blessed be the name of the Lord. He walketh through dry place, seeking rest, and finding none. Then said I, will return to my house from whence I came. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name. It's St. Mark. Sorry, St. Mark is a text. Not Matthew, St. Mark. St. Mark 12, 43 to 44. And he called unto him his disciples and said unto them, verily I say unto you, that this poor widow has cast more in than all they that which had cast into the treasury. For all they did cast in of their abundance, but she of her want did cast in all that she had, even all her living. Blessed name of the Lord. Faith. Without faith is impossible to please God. And so the widow gave her best. Unlike others who gave just to be seen to say that they give. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Oh, she had little but she gave it. Oh, blessed be the name of the Lord. So I say to her, you check your worship. You know me up. Give up the little bit that you have. Yes, I give my heart. Oh, blessed be the name of the Lord. Every one of a gift. Oh, every one of a gift this morning. Oh, blessed be the name of the Lord. Yes, brothers and sisters, we are called to give this type of worship. Like I, like Abel, like the widow, we are called to honor God by giving our best in worship and in all we do for Him. Oh, when we come to worship, we need to come with a joy. Oh, come with reverence and honor for our Creator. When we offer service to God, we should do it wholeheartedly without reservation. We should foster as a church climate of giving God thanks, giving God our best in all we do. Yes. Yes, that is acceptable worship. That is acceptable worship. Oh, yes. That is acceptable worship. Oh, bless the name of Jesus. And as we see, oh, in verse 3 of the text, Genesis 4, oh, when we look at unacceptable worship, and in the process of time it came to pass that Cain brought up the fruit of the ground and offered unto the Lord. Verse 5, but unto Cain and to his offering he had not respect, and Cain was very wroth. Imagine you come with your gift. Oh, and it is not accepted. And already your boy is angry and dejected. Already. Because many times when you're out here and somebody says, no, what you've done is wrong. Sometimes you want to find out, what have I done? What have I done for you to say that I'm wrong? But no, you don't even take the time out to ask. You start to build up angerness. No, rage already. Blessed be the name of the Lord. And so, the Bible tells us in 1 John 3 and verse 12, not as Cain, who was of that wicked one, and slew his brother, and wherefore slew he him, because his own works were evil, and his brother's righteous. So we say here, check your worship. Even though Cain, as we said, the fruit and great gift could be accepted. That is a part of what, you know, they were taught back there in the Leviticus law.
They could have bring
it. But his intention was not to bring the best. His intention was just to come anyway. And his intention was his heart wasn't clean. Blessed be the name of the Lord. And I said to you, my brothers and sisters, as the sermon has said, I went to church one day or one night and my heart wasn't right, but something, or something got a hold of me. And so we pray this morning that the Spirit will get a hold in the name of Jesus. Oh, that you'll change us, mighty God. Oh, that we'll be accepted according to the gift in the name of Jesus. Yes, an acceptable gift, an acceptable worship. Cain presented some of his crop. He just takes some of the crop. He didn't look for the best ones. But God did not accept Cain and his gift. This made Cain very angry. And he looked dejected. Cain wanted to worship God his way. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Not my way, but thy be done. And so we will ask, why God did not accept his offering? We see it was not what Cain brought to God. It was the attitude. It was the attitude. Yes, that prevailed in the person that brought the gift. Cain did not go out and find the best. He did not culture and choose a good, suitable product. He's just carrying it in. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Not because you have to offer a gift, we will just take anything. No. Cain just did some of the harvest without bothering to see if it was acceptable and present it to the Lord. God looked into Cain's heart and see that he did not bring his best. Cain's attitude was that, I will come and make an offering, but I will do it in my own terms, in my own way. Blessed be the name of the Lord. My own way. We don't want to follow the song that said we do it his own way. No, but we want to be according as the Lord would have it. Act of obedience, not act of disobedience. We need to check our worship offering. Oh, we see in the book of Amos, yes, all the children of Israel had fallen into the habit. Blessed be the name of Jesus. Amos 5, 21 to 24. Yes, I ate, I despise your feast day. I will not smell in your solemn assembly. Though ye offer me burnt offering and your meat offering, I will not accept them. Neither will I regard the peace offering of your fat beasts. Take thou away from me the noise of thy song, for I will not hear the melody of thy vows. But let judgment run down as water, and righteousness as a mighty stream. Blessed be the name. It's gonna be chaos. Come on. Oh, blessed be the name of the Lord. Here is my worship, mighty God. I keep my worship. Accept our worship, Lord. All of our worship. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Let it be pleasing to you. The Lord is the one that searches the heart. Blessed be the name of the Lord. And so I remind us, my brothers and sisters, as we continue to serve the Lord, as we continue to offer him our best, let's make sure it is our best. Oh, let's make sure it's our best. Oh, with only nothing, give ourselves away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. With only nothing. What did the Lord say to Cain? Cain, why are you so angry and dejected? If you do well, you will be accepted. Oh, but if you refuse, if you refuse, watch out. Watch out. Sin. Oh, sin. Yes. God told Cain that if he gets his heart right, his worship and service would be accepted. No, but Cain get jealous of Abel. He went and take Abel's life. Blessed be the name of the Lord. And so our Lord knows everything, and he asks, Cain, where is your brother? Where is Abel, your brother? And we know the story well. Cain said, am I my brother's keeper? Am I my brother's keeper? Oh, come on. Part of worship is to be concerned. Oh, is to be concerned about the brother. Is to be concerned about our sister. Oh, is to be concerned about the children. Oh, is to be concerned about our elderly. Mighty God, we see so much things happening in the news. They even set ablaze elderly. Oh, we pray against the evil that is going on. Oh, the art of men. God said that there is a proper way to worship and serve from the heart. God wants our worship and service voluntarily. Touching the heart of God with our worship will cause God to touch the heart of man. We can see that God always responds to worship, yes. Because we see here, Cain and Abel, it was that time to worship. And our Lord wasn't sleeping. Oh, he didn't slumber nor sleep. He was awake. And so as they bring their offering, oh, many times as church family, we are not connected because we are bringing an acceptable sacrifice. Yeah. art. Oh, art is missing in the worship. Art is missing in our giving. Oh, blessed be the name of the Lord. Worship allows us to minister to God. God constantly ministers to us. Oh, he blesses us. He meets our need. And so, we need to worship in giving it the opportunity to minister to. It is part of our spiritual ministry. Yes, 1 Peter 2 and verse 9 encourages and tells us, yes, we are a ruler, but we are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a peculiar people, and he should show forth the praises of him. Yes, check our worship, that he should show forth the praise of him who had called you out of darkness into his marvelous light. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Yes. The first thing the priest would do back then, before he intercede on behalf of the people, he would minister to the Lord. Those sacrifices, he would minister to the Lord. And so you and I, our new royal priesthood, our first and foremost duty as being royal is to minister to God. Yes, if we want to touch the heart of God and minister to him, it can't be about us. It got to be about him. Psalms 96 verse 8. Give unto the Lord the glory due unto his name. Bring an offering and come into his courts. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Check your offering this morning, my brothers and sisters. Cain and Abel's sacrifice also represent their level of commitment to God. What is your commitment level today, my brothers and sisters? What is your commitment level? Are you 10% committed? Are you 50% committed? Are you 95% committed? You have the answer already. Anything less than 100 is unacceptable. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Anything less than our absolute. Yes. Anything less. All is unacceptable. Yes. Matthew 10, 38, 39. As the Lord give us this charge, if we want to give him our all. And he that taketh not his cross and follow it after me is not worthy of me. He that findeth his life shall lose it. And he that loseth his life for my sake shall find it. Yes. Brothers and sisters, it's a call to us today. Check our worship. You and I need to be total sold out. Why should we hold out to the one who never held out on us? Why would we hold back any amount of percent of our life from a God who always given us the best, who gave the greatest sacrifice of his son, dying on the cross, so that we might know the depth, the width, the breadth of his love? Today I challenge us. What can we offer to God? We can offer our time. We can offer our praise. We can offer God our thanks because he has been good. My brothers and sisters, in closing, whatever you decide to offer to God, make sure it is your best. Make sure you give it first. God bless you today as we keep him first. In Jesus' name. Amen. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Amen. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Amen. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Amen. Yes, we want to challenge some heart this morning. Is there any heart among us who have not yet started out, who have not yet given God a chance, who have come this morning with a gift, a broken heart? Yes, you are at the right place, my brothers and sisters. You can give him a chance. Oh, he never sleep nor slumber. He's there ever waiting for you to come. Come to him. All in that labor and heavy laden, he will give us rest. Will you stand today, my brothers and sisters? Will you stand today? Come on, let's stand. Blessed be the name of the Lord. And is there any among us who want to make that start? Is there any among us who want to make that start? Who want to make sure that their offering, their sacrifice of worship is being accepted? Blessed be the name of the Lord. You can just raise your hand as we pray for you this morning. You can just raise your hand as we pray, as we lift you up before the Lord. Because he's the one that do the joy. He's the one that made the difference. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Is there any young one among us who want to sign out to follow?
Music fades, and all is stripped away. And I simply